Hi, and welcome to this B1UP e-learning session, where we look at Kanban customization, and we look at the visuals and actions you have. So this is a short one, but if we look at what is in here, we of course have a name. That makes sense. Just write whatever name should be up here. The data SQL, we have a separate e-learning on it, but what is the supported columns and keywords is here. The column SQL, which columns we have in the Kanban board, and support columns. And then we come down to the visual and actions. So first up, just outside the visual and actions you have, if you want to have this configuration work in a dashboard widget, so is the customer allowed to, or the end user, you can say, is that they allowed to use them as a widget, or is they only allowed to use them as a universal function? This is mostly used if you use dynamic syntax in the data SQL, then you normally only want to have it part of universal function. But again, separately learning on that. We have restore buttons, we have delete buttons. You can delete the out-of-the-box object Kanban boards, and you can bring them back in the restore section of the main menu. You can also always restore. Have you made a change that you regret? You can just restore them back the out-of-the-box. Of course, you can restore your own. So that's your responsibility. But let's have a look at the visual and actions as this video is about. So first up is the object type, meaning what kind of object is the different cards on the Kanban board. In this case, it's opportunity, but you can see there's tons of different things. And as we go along, request more if you feel like there's more things that should be able to be turned into a Kanban board. If you choose none, then nothing will happen if you double click. And if you feel you're missing something, again, you can ask us, but until then, you can use what is called custom. And if you choose custom, you can choose a universal function that should happen when you double click. And for example, I have made a small one here. If I just update it so we can see this one, which is just a macro that says open form of object type 97, which is opportunities, and with Kanban value number, that number, so we get the primary key out of the specific card. So doing that, it will actually do exactly the same as the out-of-the-box system here. Of course, you wouldn't do this in this case, because why do something we already implemented? But had you had some kind of, you wanted to go to business partner for some reason, you wanted to go to item code or whatever, you could actually just make a universal function that tells exactly what should happen. So let's go back. So that's the first two fields. Then we have the card width and height, which is pixels. So should you have some fields that are too long, now we can see these fits fairly good, but let's imagine you had a customer, or you had lots of customers, very long names, and you wanted to have more room. You can simply go in and make them bigger and smaller. The smallest you can make it is 50, the biggest you can make it is 1000. So this was 200, let's try to make it 400 just to see the difference. So now we have a lot more room to put in a description, but of course with the drawback at that we need a bigger screen to have all columns, or we need some scroll bars. So that's size versus kind of, overview that you're working here. So if you wanted to make it even smaller, we could do that, but then there will be a lot more page breaking and different, to the point where something even could overlap. So that's up to you and your data, how big things should be. We have tried to make it as out of the box as we feel like, but it's of course up to you if you want to take changes of this. Then there's the column move action. As mentioned, there's some out of the box, like for example, opportunity have the options to either update stages or update its status when lost. We have the documents where you can choose whether you can manipulate the approved, unapproved. You can use header UDFs. We have a separate e-learning on that called sales order sample. Production order status can be manipulated. Project management status can be manipulated, and the service call status can be manipulated at this time. Again, if you have another object in SAP that you feel like this should be able to have a Kanban board with different columns and move along, tell us about it. Go to our development request page, the feature request, put in a feature request, and so on. But until then, this is what we support. And if you use header UDF, you simply write the UDF field here, use something, so we know which field it is you want to change. Again, separate e-learning called sales order sample that shows exactly how that works. If you put none, it's simply not allowed to move anything. So if I try to move, it's not dragging along now. So the Kanban more or less becomes a visual board only, but that could be needed until we support the field that you want at some point. In this case, it was stages because the column value is the stage field. Then below the column move action, we have the show new entry button, which fairly simple, just go in and make a new button down here that opens up the object type that is selected. And if you want it to be called something else instead of new, you could call it new PPR, for example, and that would be the name of this entry down here. Or you can say you don't want it and it will not be shown. Finally, over here, we have the user settings. And this is where you can go in and set up that only certain users are allowed to see this Kanban board. Let's say it contains some sensitive information and only manager would allow to be shown. You could put in manager and you could put in build the user that, and then that means that only those two users will be able to show, to choose this Kanban board. Or you could go and say everyone but manager and build. So it works exactly the same as the other user system we have in our system. So that is all the visuals and actions we have. More will perhaps come along as we go along with this information, but these are the basic ones that make sense in here. So we're done. Thank you for attending. Hope it was beneficial.